All right, what's good, people? Once again, it's the Beard God. You know what I'm saying? Sig U Battle League, Push a Pin Battle League, Torture Chamber, NOC Battles. You know what I'm saying? We got our hands all over the place. You know what I'm saying? So, Battle Rap Illuminati. Back again. Got to talk about the QP situation, RBE. And bullpen, talking about clean paper. Now, we just had an event, Halloween Havoc 2K17, dope event. He battled Dud the Phenom. Listen, I'm hearing the internet go crazy over the homie, talking all crazy. And I'm not trying to pick sides. I don't even want to really get involved in it. Because at the end of the day, his credit is good over here. Business is good over here. We just had an event last week. Like I said, he was there. You know what I'm saying? And we got another event in January. And I look forward to him being there. So, this is what I want to say. You know, to the battlers and the battle leagues and stuff out there. Man, y'all got to have... you got to have your shit straight. Not saying y'all don't. Y'all gotta have y'all shit straight when it comes down to y'all contracts and it come down to how y'all negotiate y'all deals and stuff like that. You know, if so many leagues feel as though, you know, homie is no showing or not showing up or whatever the case may be, then y'all got by right, y'all have the right to not book him. You know what I'm saying? And that goes for any battle rapper, like not just him. I mean, there's a lot of battle rappers out here that are stealing deposits. There's a lot of battle rappers out here that's no showing or backing out or agreeing to battles, knowing they're not going to show up or knowing they don't have the transportation to get there or knowing that they double book. And I definitely believe that has to stop. That has to come to an end. As far as QP goes, though, I was watching the homie Frank, blogger in the cut. I was watching one of his blogs and he was saying, you know, he showed up to the joint in Milwaukee. Then he showed up to another league in Ohio, I think. Then he showed up to Sig U here in Jersey, but he didn't show bullpen. He didn't show up to RBE. I think that people need to, before y'all jump out the window with shit, sometimes y'all need to actually figure out like what the real behind the scenes situation is. Like, why is it that he showed up to the leagues that he showed up to when he didn't show up to the other ones that he didn't show up to? Ask yourself them questions. And this ain't no shade on them, because I don't know I don't know the behind the scenes business and all like that. But ask yourselves a question. Like, did he get paid? Was he getting paid? You know what I'm saying? Did he get a deposit? Did he not get a deposit? You know, it could have been something where shit came up. You know what I'm saying? Life happens. Not making no excuses for the homie. I'm just saying, I think before people jump out the window and ridicule people and assassinate their character and all of that shit, I think people need to actually, you know, get the facts. You know what I'm saying? Stop acting off of emotion all the damn time. We had a situation where we had two battles that didn't go down in our last event. Amazing D-Boy had backed out. J. Crew was a no-show, but we found out his situation. He was booked or whatever. So it's like, we didn't go on the line and say, yo, fuck these niggas. They banned. We never bringing them back again. And don't y'all book them because they known to know. Like, I think people be so quick to jump out the window. And all it takes is that one person to set shit off. Like, oh, such and such no show now. Like, oh, he no show. Oh, we not booking him. And so, I mean, if people that have experienced that with him, if they feel as though they'll never bring him back or they'll never book him again or whatever the case may be, then they got the right to, because, you know, it cost them bread or, you know, lack thereof that they could have made, whatever the case may be. I'm only speaking on behalf of our league. We ain't had no problems. You know what I'm saying? We had no problems with QP. He showed up. He was on time. You know what I'm saying? He met all the stipulations that we had in the contract and it was all good. Once again, not to throw shade on y'all or not to shit on y'all other leagues that had him booked and he didn't come through. But y'all just gotta ask yourself, man, like, what can y'all do as leagues to be better at the end of the day on the business and, you know, to make sure that people are there. Like, you know, you gotta have a respectable platform, but you also gotta do respectable business. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, a lot of leagues out here, they have names that are heavy. They have cars that are heavy. They have, you know, big names that be on the cards and stuff like that. That's cool. But some of them behind the scenes, the business don't be right. You know what I'm saying? If the business not right, then you'll find yourself getting in those type of situations. But also, you got battle rappers that just be on some stealing deposits, on some old culture vulture type shit, in it for the wrong reasons. And I'm not saying that that's him. I'm just speaking in general. So, you know, people got to be able to know that everybody's relationship is going to be different. Like, everybody's relationship with a battle rapper isn't going to be the same. Every league's relationship with a battle rapper is not going to be the same. Every battle rapper's relationship with each league is not going to be the same. There's going to be some leagues that fuck with certain battle rappers more than others, and there's going to be certain battle rappers that fuck with certain leagues more than others. You know what I'm saying? So, with that being said, you know, I understand where ARP's coming from. He feels as though he has to do what he has to do as far as taking the legal action, based on, you know, what happened with QP, whether, you know, the deposit money or the money that was supposedly, that could have been made, that, you know, they didn't make because they had to drop the ticket sale price or whatever, or, you know, people that decided not to come because the battle wasn't whatever. Like, you know, he kind of took an L in that situation. As far as Gems, I understand Gems feeling some type of way. You done wrote for this man, you done prepare for this man, whatever the case may be. But from my understanding, from what he said in his joint, he got a deposit. So it wasn't like it was for nothing. You know what I'm saying? Now, as far as him, the battle not happening, he probably wasn't able to get that second half. So that definitely probably have him upset because, you know, it's messing his money up. And if people are upset because these things is messing your money up, then you got every right in the world to sit in there and feel some type of way. You know what I'm saying? Anybody mess your money up, you definitely gonna have a problem with that. So that makes sense. It makes sense for people being in the uproar. But at the end of the day, if nobody has heard from the man, seen the man, talked to the man, you can't be so quick to just act off of emotion. You know what I'm saying? It might been some serious shit going down. But then, like, with the no-show shit, my thing is, I don't know what time the event started, but I know before the event started, I know Gems had his blog out. So you had your blog out before the event started, then clearly you knew something. You know what I'm saying? You knew something. Somebody told you at the ARP made an announcement, or case being the ARP made an announcement that he wasn't going to come. How he know? You know what I'm saying? Like, was it a certain time limit that, or a certain time frame that he had to be there? And if he wasn't there, it was automatically going to be considered a no-show or a back out. Like, somebody had to say something. So if QP communicated with ARP that he wasn't going to be able to make it, that's not a no-show. That's a back out. There's a difference. So people got to stop going around running the whole no-show shit. No-show shit is if he knew he was supposed to battle Gems and he down in Miami somewhere on the beach clipping his fucking toenails and, you know, he just don't have no plans on coming and don't communicate, don't say shit, don't care. You know what I'm saying? But if he reached out to that man, ARP, and he told him, like, look, bro, whatever, whatever, I'm not going to be able to make it, then cool. You know what I'm saying? But like I said, we don't know. We don't really know what the behind the scenes. I seen part of ARP's thing when he came out and he was talking about, you know, the legal action and all of that. And, you know, this shit got to come to a stop. Yeah, I agree. The shit definitely got to stop. But I think if QP reached out to ARP and he told him that he wasn't going to be able to make it for whatever the reason is, then I think the ARP is wrong for going about it the way that he did. You know what I'm saying? And everybody bashing, you know what I'm saying, the man's name. But that's just my opinion. I don't know if they had a conversation. And if they did, I don't know what the conversation was. That's neither here or there. At the end of the day, salute to RBE for putting on a dope event for what I'm hearing. Salute to everybody that's out here working, that's grinding. Salute to all the leagues. And people just got to do better, man. League owners, we got to do better. Leagues got to do better. Battle rappers got to do better. Fans got to do better. Like, the culture has to just, you know, do different things to make it better. You know what I'm saying? I definitely believe there has to be some more organization and some more structure in there. And, you know, people are going to get the contracts. The contracts need to be tight where, you know, there's going to be clauses if you don't show up, clauses if you show up late, deductions if you show up late or if you don't show up on time, or a situation where you're going to have to pay a certain amount of money back if, you know, you end up not making it. There's a lot of different things. And I think that with the whole battle rap league union that's being worked on, I think that's a good move. But at the end of the day, you know, people gotta understand in real life sometimes things do happen, but this shit is like a job. Regardless if you battling for free or you battling and getting paid for it, you know, the lines of communication have to stay open. You know what I'm saying? You have to let if you got a battle going on, you got to let the people that you battling for know what's going on, whether you're going to make it, whether you're not going to be able to make it. You know what I'm saying? Because that's where the respect comes in at. So, man, that's pretty much all I got to say about that, man. I don't know why he did it. You know, if it was on purpose, if he really got some shit going on, I don't know. But until y'all actually hear from that man and talk to that man, it's just not cool, man. Everybody, you know, trashing this nigga name on the internet. Like, the shit crazy. I ain't got no problem with him. He good with Sig U. And like I said, January 27th, y'all see him versus Stampede. Gonna be a crazy battle. Make sure y'all follow us at Push Your Pen on Instagram, Twitter, hashtag Sig U. Basically anything, you know, all the stuff comes up. Y'all follow the YouTube channel, the Torture Chamber channel, the Push Your Pen channel, the Step You Ain't Game Up channel, the NOC Battles channel. We all over, man. We not playing no games. We working, man. 2017 was good. 2018 is going to be great. And I holla at y'all, man. Beard God signing out.